talking with Jennifer Luitwieler about Advent. About your book and the accidental runner thing and the poo thing.
Oh, yeah.
Just figure that out.
Sure. The book is called Run With Me, An Accidental Runner and the Power of Poo, because the impetus for running for me was our dog. I should say the dog because he's not mine. I don't claim him. We are not friends. We never will. But he was pooping in my house, and so in order to train him, I thought, okay, well, you know, it always falls to the person who doesn't want the job. So we started training outside, and the more I ran with him, the more I could run. So eventually I got to the place where I could leave him at home. And now I run without him, which is nice. I just submitted a blog post about a parable, and actually I didn't end up writing a reflection on the parable, but rather instead focused on how this is a parable I've always struggled with and being okay with that. Mm. And I don't understand it. I still don't understand it. And I can either avoid it and just pretend it's not there, or I can chase the rabbits down the holes and see where it takes me. Mm. And resting in that tension and being able to say, I'm okay without that knowledge. In fact, his coming doesn't rely on my understanding at all anyway. I'm not really even a part of that picture. Right. He doesn't require my cognition for him to exist and be mighty. Hmm. And so I find myself thinking more about how to slow down, not my legs, but my physical efforts of running from here and there and disappointment and that choir concert and blah, blah, blah. How do I make space and time for the things that are really important, not necessarily the stuff of the season, but the meaning. In fact, I just said to my husband the other day, and he totally rolled his eyes at me. I said, I just feel like we spend so much time thinking about what to buy and how to budget that we're not making anything magical. And he laughed because I actually used the term magical. Right. Just say that. I said, yes, I just said that because there should be something magical and inspiring and reflective about the season that we overlook when we're busting our butts trying to get wherever we're supposed to be that doesn't matter. I continue to run. I don't have a race set on my schedule, but I will do the Oklahoma City at least half marathon in the spring. So that's, you know, 4 or 5 months from now. But in the meantime, I continue to run with the thoughts of my roots. I've been thinking a lot about that lately and how I'm a Pittsburgh transplant to Tulsa, Oklahoma. And so go Steelers.
Yeah.
I see your terrible towel there. Yeah.
Where in Pittsburgh?
I grew up in Moon.
Okay.
That other people actually don't know. So I'm working on a novel set in downtown Tulsa in the 1920s, which a lot of people don't know. There was a very big race riot here in 1921 that burned a big part of our city down, and it's still rebuilding now. And business leaders don't like to talk about it. It's very much a shameful part of the past, but the more I spend researching it, the more I fall in love with this place where I am, and I'm finding that I want to embrace that for my children. So really just thinking about where we're from and is what makes a place a home.
Very good.
So that's the one.
Because they're building all the memories and they're natives, you know, so.
Right, they are. They're Okies.
Yeah.
Yay!
Thanks so much.
Sure. Thanks, Lisa.
All right. Bye-bye.
Yeah.